Hey guys, welcome back to Campbell Workshop. Today we are going to make a branch of small red flowers, Japanese quince, and we are going to make about 10 open flowers for each branch. Before we start, if you haven't subscribed to our channel, don't forget to click on the subscribe button below so you won't miss any of our new tutorials. First, we start with cutting the petals according to the template. A pair of small scissors and a small paperclip will be very helpful in the cutting process. We will need about 50 pieces for 10 open flowers. Then we need to shape the petals. Use the tweezers to hold the tail of the petal and bend it into 90 degrees. After that, we gather the tip of the petal with their tweezers and expand in the middle, so you can have a round petal. Do the same to all of the petals. Take out a piece of yellow crepe paper as the flower center. Cut a paper into 2 cm height and cut them into small fringes. We will only need about 2 × 2 cm fringes as the flower center. Bend the loop on the 18 gauge wire and the 24 gauge wire. For the 24 gauge wire, we will only need them in 9 cm long. Add a bit of hot glue to the loop and wrap the yellow paper to it. Now we are going to attach the bent petals to the flower center with some UHU glue. Apply the glue to the tail of the petals and attach the petals evenly. We will need a flower on 18 gauge wire as a main stem, and the other 9 flowers on a 9 cm long 24 gauge wire. They should look like this. Now we are going to make some small budding flowers. Cut these small round petals according to the template. And form them into a small ball shape. Then we can attach the petals onto the hot glue ball on the 24 gauge wire stem. Add 3 to 4 petals to make it into a budding flower. When we are done, we need to trim the budding flower into its ideal shape. Take out a brown crepe paper and cut the bottom leaves for the open flowers, and we will need about 5 pieces for each flower. And we attach the brown leaves with some UHU glue. For the budding flower, we also use the same bottom leaves, but in green color. We will need about 3 to 4 pieces for each one. Then we wrap 2/3 of the stem with some brown floral tape. Do the same to all of the flower stems. To make the branch a little bit more realistic, we also need some loose leaves. We need to twist the end of each leaf so they are easier to be wrapped onto the branch. Take out a new 18 gauge wire and wrap the green leaves with the brown floral tape. Then we can slowly add the open flowers and the budding flowers accordingly. You can always use a pair of pliers to adjust the flower heads. I have also used some small 18 gauge wire to make some small bundles and reattach it to the main stem. It is very flexible on how you put the branch together. You can also add some more flowers to it. We are done. Thank you for watching the video and I hope you like it. We have noticed 80% of our audience is not subscribed yet. If you like our video, please don't forget to like, comment and subscribe to our channel. It will really help our channel to grow. Stay tuned for our weekly tutorials. And all our templates are available on our Etsy store. Check them out as well. See you guys next week.